Hi everyone, Ronnie Rowe here again for another week of Ronnie Rowe Designs Counted Cross Stitch. Got a lot to talk about today. Things that we said we were going to do from last week's show. Got some pictures to show you this week. Got to write some things down. Some new pictures. We're going to talk about morning light progress with that. Some new, like I say, new designs. I'm going to show you some pictures of some ships I have done in the past, frame, and some comments I've gotten this week from you folks out there. First of all, a little housekeeping. If you would, I'd very much appreciate it if you click on the subscribe button on this if you're watching it. That'll help me out a whole lot. So I really do appreciate that. And again, if you have any comments or anything that you see could improve the videos that I do every week, other than housekeeping, what's behind me? This is a mess. I've been in here this week trying to clean up, but if you look from last week's video to this week's, you can't tell how much happened. So, but anyway, that's neither here nor there. That's what's happened. I hope each and every one of you have had a great week of Thanksgiving is over. Now we're looking forward to the Christmas holiday season. I know people are out shopping. They're out spending a lot of money. I've been told by the news that people are spending a lot this year. So, but anyway, I hope you're out doing that, making the loved ones happy and got you go. We got our Christmas tree up. My wife put Christmas tree up this week. Looks very nice. And so we're glad that's done and out of the way. Got several parties to go to, several outings with friends over the holidays. So we'll go into that a little bit more once those events happen. But for right now, first thing I want to start off with tonight is morning light. How are we doing with morning light? Well, I have been stitching some this week. I've gotten along. I'm on my next rows down below the sky part, and I'll show you that in a minute. But first of all, I got an email from Tammy this week, which I was thrilled. And Tammy has been stitching Morning Light along with me, and she's got the whole top done. I mean, she sent me pictures of this, and it is fantastic. I am so happy to see somebody actually stitch one of my designs being stitched. I don't get to see that very often. And so anyway, that's a thrill for me to see that. And Tammy, you're doing great. Keep me posted and anyone else. And one reason I guess I'm glad is because I know a lot of people that have my designs. A lot of folks don't complete a lot of my designs, especially the larger projects, because they take a while to do, and not hard to do, but it just takes a while. And I think people go on to other things. But anyway, I hope they do enjoy the designs once you're stitching and getting into it. And Tammy, you've done a great job. Thank you very, very much for sharing your progress with me on Morning Light. Okay, Morning Light. Where am I on Morning Light? Right. Oh, before I show you, again, if you email me and tell me you like Morning Light, you want a PDF file, I'll send you one. And any of you folks out there that have sent me an email and you haven't gotten one yet, send it again. I mean, I look over my emails and sometimes I might miss one or two. So I don't intentionally do it, but it happens. So if you didn't get anything, please send me another email and I'll shoot that Morning Light PDF file out to you. Where I am right now on Morning Light. It's wrinkled. This is not framed or anything. Where I am on Morning Light right now, I have got the sky. The sky is all done across here, coming down with the morning light. This is the first little peak of the building that's going to be here. And of course, this side over here, we got some trees and everything. And this right here is a wood pile. This is going to be the wood pile. And along in here, we'll have the pathway going back underneath this tree that's going to come down in this area. So this don't look like much. It's all wrinkled up, as you can see. I've been stitching it. Whoops, been stitching this thing. And I've still got over here to go and some more across the bottom, and I'll be through with this. But that's where I am right now on Morning Light. I've got the frame all built for Morning Light. I have that here somewhere. This is, like I told you, I build my own frames. I've got the frame all built, got it all Took some, got it shiny and everything. The back of it don't look like much what I do right now, but of course, no one's gonna see that anyway because the way I frame them, they'll have paper across the back. So anyway, did the routing on this, did the corners, and so turned out pretty good. So morning light is going to go in this frame, of course, with two pieces of mat board. Haven't selected that yet, but I will in the coming weeks. And we, when I do get ready to frame this, we're going to sit down and we'll go through that process again, showing you how I cut the mat board and putting all of this together. So anyway, that's morning light for this week. I'm going to continue stitching, see how we do next week. One thing came up in my email this week, Woodlawn Plantation, the 2023 Woodlawn Plantation Needlework Show. That's a big show that's in outside of Washington, D.C. at Woodlawn Plantation. And they're going to start taking entries for that on December the 15th. And it's open to anyone in the needlework that does, excuse me, cross stitch. You can enter a piece, you can have it sent there, you can carry it up there if you're close by. But they do an excellent job up at Woodlawn, and this is a very, very good show. It's seen by lots and lots of people go through and look at the needlework and beautiful pieces of work. I mean, just absolutely gorgeous work up there. I've been putting work in there for years and years, and I was fortunate enough several years ago to put one of my pieces called Flight. That's the one I had with the moon, the space shuttle going up, the Leonardo da Vinci, and everything in the Wright brothers across the bottom, Flight. And I was lucky enough, I'll share this because it's sitting in my office, nobody sees it. I was lucky enough at Woodlawn to win the director's award on that. This is a ribbon I got from Woodlawn Plantation several years ago for the picture Flight that I did. So I was very, very pleased about that. Very, very honored to get the director's award. So anyway, that was nice. I felt good about that. Talked about that, talking the new design. Now, the new design we're doing, I told you that we're looking at doing something new after morning light, and I had liked what I did with the harbor scenes with Mystic Harbor and Snowbound. We've shown you those before, and I want to do something along that line. So what I have come up with is a sketching out of some rocks across here. We're going to colorize all of this as a little pier with a house at the end with the sky in the back. And so this is what I've come up with so far that we're going to be putting into the computer and working this. So this will probably be a new design, one of the new ones. I'm not quite sure yet how I'm going to do the rocks and how all of this is going to work together, but we'll put it in Affinity Designer, Affinity Photo, and we'll come up with something with that new design. So that's going to take a while, but once we get into the progress of that, I'll show you on the screen in Affinity Designer, in Affinity Photo, and the other programs, how we're going about doing that. So that'll probably be the next project. I mentioned to you a lot that I go to the YM, I do a lot of swimming, and I've given it some thought about doing something, not me particular, but swimming, a picture about swimming. And I've got some ideas in the back of my head about what I want to do with that, but I'm still playing around with that. So we'll have that coming in the coming weeks. And so I want to do something along that line. So we'll see what happens there. Got some pictures this week I'd like to show you. These are some older pictures that when I was designing, I wanted to do something with ships, and I wanted to do something with my black and whites. So I was doing the black and whites, you know, the pen and ink designs. But anyway, I wanted to do some ships and old ships. And so I want to show two of them to you tonight that I have done in the past. I got a squeaky chair here. This is one of them. Both of these frames you see are frames I built. And this particular one right here, as you can see, that is one of the ships I did that was supposed to be just black and white. And I made it brown. I put a brown color on this instead of the typical 844, the black. And so everything white on here is a material. And the frames on these I built the same way that I have done other frames. But on this one in particular right there, I went to my local Home Depot or Lowe's, everywhere it was, and I bought this molding. You can buy this rope molding. So I put that around the frame, and well, that turned out pretty good. And I have three of these ships that I was doing during that period of my wanting to do ships, I guess. But this is one of them. The other one, very, very similar, but it's a little bit different. And there's another one of the sailing ships. And so this turned out fairly good with the rope and everything. And I've got these out there. They're on my website. They're on the Estee site. And so anyway, these are fairly simple to do. They're all one color. And of course, you can do these in any color that you like. But it's the same as the pen and ink designs that I've done in the past. So anyway, that's I wanted to show you those. What else this week? The new design, we're going to be doing that. Inputs from everyone. I've gotten a ton of requests this week to do all kinds of things. Questions about floss, questions of, can you change floss? Do I have conversion kits for DMC versus other things? And I don't particularly, but I do know out on the web there, on the internet, you can get conversion instructions for going from DMC to all different types of things, threads that you might want to use. That is for, and as far as materials, what kind of materials do I use? I always use 18 count. A lot of people want to do this on 20, a lot of my stuff on 22 count, and so which is perfectly fine. And one of the previous videos, I did show you how I do all the measurements, and so I could cut my material and get the proper distance from the design to the edge of your material for the matting using mat board. So anyway, you can go back and look at one of those. But questions along that line, other questions about how do I come up with an idea for this? I don't know, something that kind of just strikes me and I'm interested in, I'll come up with something. So it's basically the way I've did it. And I know I've always kind of gone with a series of type things, like when I was doing the cats, all in the eyes of the cats and then the dogs. One lady asked me if I'm going to do any more dogs. Well, probably not. I'm not sure, unless somebody really wants a particular dog in black and white, like I've done the rest of them, I might do that. So, but what I'd like for each one of you to do is send me a note of something that you think would be a great subject for me to do or along that line. My work is, you know, basically what I do and how I've been going about this. So if you've got a subject matter, that's really a tough thing to do, is come up with a subject matter, something you want to see in cross stitch. And so if you'd send me a note on that or post one of the notes to this video, I would appreciate it very, very much. Next week, we're going to go back through Morning Light. Hopefully next week, I'm going to show you the start of this new design, and we're going back into the programs and doing some things with that and let you see that. Don't know much other than that that's going on. I know that the 2023 Nashville Needlework Market is coming up in March of next year, and I know they have a lot of people participate in that. I'm not going to be going to the Needlework Market next year. One reason, it's a wonderful market. It's run fantastic by Larry and Beth Johnson. They do a great job with this, fantastic job. I don't know if anybody could do any better, but I'm not going to be going. We're at the stage of our life right now. It's a long trip, the packing up and going and everything. And so it's just it takes its toll. So we're gonna stick right now, I guess, to the virtual shows that they have online through Event Hub, the folks that put those on. So we'll be doing those next year with some new designs. And a lot of these designs right now, that we're doing, Morning Light and all that, that'll be going out to Rod and Hoffman Distributing. They'll be taking all of these at some point in time and sending them out to the various shops and other distributors all around everywhere. So, but anyway, that's what's going on right now in Ronnie Rowe's world. I'm going to try to clean this mess up behind me again this week. Not really counting on getting a lot of success there. Gonna make an attempt, but probably ain't gonna, you know, it probably gonna look the same. And I'll tell you that I've cleaned everything up, and no, I haven't. But anyway, that's going to be one of my big things this coming week. Don't know anything else. Go to my Estee store. I've got an Estee store out there, and you can click on the little button down below, everywhere it is, and click on that. And also my website, you can find all of my designs that I have out there. I'm running some specials right now on a lot of my designs with 50% off. So you might get a chance to look at it, see something you like. And if you don't, that's fine, but just take a look anyway. So, but anyway, until next week, as always, keep stitching. I hope you have a fantastic week. And please, please be safe. And I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.